inside. Nobody claims to see the light. It seems to me that all of us have lost our patience. 'Cause everyone thinks they're right, and nobody thinks that there just might be more than one road to our final destination. But I'm not. Someone else to blame. All the holes and answers that are clearly showing.
Guys, just like when we spoke about the transporter, the first half of this race is just going to be to make sure we stay up there, stay out of trouble, stay out of the wall, stay on the lead lap.
Alright, guys. We are here today at Down Under. Here in Australia, for race number 10 of the Dewalt Tools Cup Series. And this race is going to be a statement for a lot of drivers. If they could make a statement here today, it might have an impact on if they can make it in the chase, or if they are just not ready for it yet. And there's a few guys I see that really need to make a statement, which is Ryan Cooper, Jacob Lawler, Dougie Shears, and that number 13 of Eric Burton. If they could either come out of here with a win or with a great finish, they are setting themselves up for them to probably, hopefully, do well until the chase starts. But we're going to have to see if that is possible as we will figure the starting grid. Back in the M&M's pretzel Toyota of Luke Walker will lead us to the green flag. Here we go. Green is out. And he's going to try to take that pretzel car to victory lane here today. But he's going to have to hold out on all these other guys because there goes the 42 right there. And there he goes. And there goes Dougie Shears. He's going to go on the apron right here. But there's the 18. And these guys are going to have a big gap over each other. Some of these guys are already off the pace. Some of these guys are already off the pace already. There's a three. There's a three of Dougie Shield going to try to go to the inside. There's a 20. There's a 22 of Hayden Klein, but there's Dougie Shields. He's going to make the pass for a lead, and Dougie Shields will lead the first lap. I thought somebody didn't get scored. But anyway, there's Sean Henley. He's going to go on the inside. He's going to make the pass. There he goes right there. There's a 17, and there's a 16. Oh, 56. Make contact. Oh, man. There's the 88. Going to be right on the inside of Dougie Shears, and Sean and Dougie got together earlier at Phoenix race number 2. It's been a while since that race, but those guys are pretty good friends. They could let things go. Is there Sean gonna take it to the lead? And here comes Lyndon Wright, and there's his teammate right behind him. Every time one Roush Fenway car is right there, there's always another one right near it. And Preston Plourde and Lyndon Wright are looking to do good here today to try to settle themselves up into a good spot to try to make the chase. Lyndon Wright has been struggling, but he's been trying to make his moves. But here comes, there goes another car we haven't really talked about too much this season since Phoenix. There's Charles Jackson going to go on the inside. He makes a little bit of contact with Eric Burton, but he prevails to get the spot. And there's a battle between Roush Fenway teammates, but Preston Plourde has been the dominant person at Roush Fenway. He's been dominating his teammates a lot this season, as he will take the lead. But there's Charles Jackson in the 9, going to pretty much try to get by him, but Preston Plourde will not let that happen. But there's Ryan Cooper, another guy we were talking about, had to make a statement in this race, and he is certainly doing that, as he will take a 3 wide for the lead. But there goes the 9 in the middle. Preston Plourde stuck on the outside line. But there's Ryan Cooper, he'll take it to the inside again. And there's Dylan Poteet. So it's going to be Ryan Cooper prevailing to try to take the lead, and he will get that bottom line. But there's Dylan Poteet, and Dylan Poteet will try to get on the inside to lead the lap as well. But there's Kyle Sanuski, second in the points, really needs a win. He could do it here today, but he's going to have to, oh man, he got loose almost. But there's the 9 car, and there's a 43, his teammate on the bottom right there. They are actually keeping it. Oh man, that was almost close. They're actually keeping it going right now, but there is the 15. 15 is going to try to take the lead from Dylan Poteet, but there's Lyndon Wright. Lyndon Wright is just staying right there. He is right there up in the top 5. Once he stayed up here, he is trying to see how good his car is to get back up to the lead. There you see the 17 is going to go back under the inside. They're not really racing too much 3 wide up here. Oh, man, 43. There's a 15, and there's a 16 going to try to take it to the inside again. Oh, my goodness. Oh, these guys are going crazy right now. There's a 17, you see them, and there's a lot of these guys way off the pace. A lot of you guys, there's like a pack of cars by themselves. So you can see these guys are, some of you guys are faster than a lot of other people. But the 11, so a lot of you guys did not get a great start on that start. James Qualls is way off the pace. He's a points leader too, and that's not really good for him. And there goes the 43. Oh man, there's the 1 of Trent Dunham. Trent Dunham's gonna go on the bottom. Oh man. Oh. They keep it going, but there's Jacob Lawler. One guy I was talking about, he really needs to make a statement, as he is putting his car to the test here today. And there's Peachy Walker. He's been quiet this season, but he has been making some noise. But Trent Dunham in that 1 machine is leading here. Earnhardt Ganassi needs a win so bad, and Trent will do anything for it. But he's going to have to hold off his good friend, Peachy Walker. But Peachy Walker is going to go on the inside with the UPS Ford. There's Jacob Lawler. And like I said, Jacob Lawler is taking no prisoners as he runs Peachy up the racetrack. Here comes Seth Cole in that 20 machine. He finished dead last in last race at Talladega, and look at him, right, bounce back. Great comeback for Seth Cole here in that 20 Toyota. For Joe Gibbs, Joe Gibbs has had a tough season, except for James Quad leading the points, but Seth is trying his best to get back up in that 20, top 20, and make a statement. He's another driver that can make that statement. And there he goes right there, and there's Eric Burton. Eric Burton's going to be right there as well. Not too much 3 wide. We've had 3 wide for the lead, but not too much 3 wide all the way around this track. But there's the 6 of Jack Rasmussen. Jack Rasmussen made his statement already by winning at Talladega. Oh, man. And he won in extreme fashion. He led like the last five laps of that race on pit strategy. But there's Sefco. Sefco not trying to let Jack Rasmussen go, but Jack Rasmussen is still fighting hard on the bottom of the racetrack, and he will get it from Sefco. But there's Charles Jackson back on the inside again. He's showing his face up in the top three, and there's Kyle Sanusky. Some of these guys have been comers and goers. They have been up to the front, and they have fallen back. And there's the 9, and there's the 6. Great battle for the lead here. They are 3 wide, but there's a 9. Well, he will just simply take it away. And there's a 15, and they'll make a little bit of contact, but they'll actually keep it going. These guys are good at keeping it going right now. And there you see, oh man, right there, where they can make a little bit of contact with each other. But there's a 6 in the middle, and there's Konstantinsky gonna try to take the lead away again. And he will. And no, Charles Jackson still holds the outside line. He would get the preferred line to take the lead back. But there's Kyle Sanusky. Oh, and Dylan Poe teammate, big contact right there. But look at the run he got in the corner. He is getting it right now. He is in second position. Oh, man. And Dylan Poe just got a burst of speed. Didn't talk about him too much until just now. He was up in the top 5, but then he fell back. But then he brought himself right back up with that boost of speed he just got. And he's trying to get past that 15 Toyota of Kyle Sanusky, who is the points leader. Well, he probably might be the points leader after this race if he can hang on to where he is now. But there's Dylan Poti. Dylan Poti going to take the inside line. There's Jacob Lawler. And, oh, man, these guys are just close right now. And there's Jacob Lawler, but they are managing to keep off each other big time. There's Dylan Poti. He will take the outside line, but Jacob Lawler will get the inside line. Look at Joseph Clark. How about him today making a show up here in the second position? And there's Joseph Clark. These guys are just showing off how good they are as drivers here in the Dewalt Cup Series by just racing each other hard, but just not putting a lot too much into it to wreck each other. But there's William Duncan, the Daytona 500 winner. He will go on the inside and he will take the lead. But here comes Linden right back at it again. Oh man, these guys make contact. But like I said, a lot of these guys are off the pace. Oh man, like James Qualls is one of them, and he's about to get lapped. As you see, he's about to get lapped soon. He's way off the pace. But there's a 32, but there's a 17. And these guys are getting close to making pit stop time. There's a 17 right out in front here. Oh, man. Oh, man. These guys make contact. Oh, Michael Jeter. Michael Jeter just ran up Trent Dunham. He knocked him in the side. And he will go up into the second position. There he goes right there. And there's Lyndon Wright. Gets a big boost from Justin Perry. And he'll go on the outside line as well. But Justin Perry, he has found himself out in front right now, with nobody challenging him. But here comes Michael Jeter in that Rubbermaid 78, and he will make the challenge. These guys are coming on time to pit soon. There's James Claude. Like I said, oh, 42. Oh, 42 has a problem. Jeremy McMurray is on the apron. He has had a flat tire, and that is a shame for him. But he's at full speed, which is, I don't get. Why is he at full speed? He was at full speed. I was scared he was going to pave the field. That would have been treacherous right there. And there goes the 81. But a lot of these Earnhardt Ganassi cars are showing their face. The 42 was up there as well. But just a lot of these guys falling off a little bit here as well. Man, these guys are giving a show up here. They have been 3 wide a little bit. You would say too much, but look at the 99. He just washed up the racetrack. Oh my goodness. Oh, contact. Connor Breeden and the 27 and the 56 to Ryan Cooper, but they managed to save it. But here comes Dougie Shears. His teammate's gonna go on the inside. Oh, 42 is down there. He's coming. He went down pit road, but there's a 27. Oh, there's a 3. Here, these guys are just doing what they gotta do right now. They are just holding it wide open. What's up? That was a 42, and they will go. Oh, they were trying to go 4 wide, but that's not gonna work. Oh man! Oh! Jesus Christ, man. Justin Perry got so close to slapping the crap out of the wall. And there's a 42. The 42 is back on the racetrack. But he is so much in the way right now. Way off the pace he is. But there's Eric Burton. And like I said, Eric Burton's got to make the statement here today to show that he could race with the big boys. And if he could do that, and if he could do that by winning a race here early in the season, he had a win last season at Charlotte. It came late, but he's really been showing that he could race here in this series this season more than last season, even though he made the chase. But this season is the test for him. But he is really showing what he's got. But there's Trent Dunham. Trent Dunham's going to go to the inside again. Trent Dunham has been very strong. There's a 20 machine of Seth Cole. Oh, shit. That's not good. Oh, man. No. We got a mess. We got somebody stopped back here. And there's James Qualls. And caution is out. We have finally had the mess. Oh, and there's James McLeod. Whoa. Oh, he's stuck. James McLeod is stuck right there. Yeah, man. It took us a while, but we finally had it happen. And Jay, the best guy that helps out is James Qualls. Because he was so close to getting out of the race. But this is a guy that does not help. James McLeod has kept his car clean for most of the races this season. The last DNF I remember him having was at Quarter Slammer. He has kept his car clean for a lot of the races this season. But that's not going to be the case this time. There goes the 13 coming down pit road. And a few of these guys coming down pit road. But Ryan Duke will stay out. I think he's 14th. He will stay out. And a few of these other guys pitting. But there's a 6th car on pit road. Let's see what happened here. Oh no, the 4 is actually on pit road. Let's see what happened here. Okay guys, this is gonna make you say, what in the world? Because it just made me say that. But watch this. Watch Ryan Cooper. He gets loose. Oh my god, Jack Rasmussen hit him. Oh, and then the 14 went right up into it. And Ryan Cooper just got bounced up. And watch him bounce up. And then he's going to tumble. While Ryan Cooper's season has just been downhill. And then you see all these guys jumbled up back here. It really wasn't too much of a crash, you would say. There's Ryan, Jim, no, I was just about, that's what happened to him. James McLeod hit the invisible 56. The 56 just spawned to pit road, and James McLeod just had nowhere to go. So, let's see what happened again. I think somebody else got some damage back there, the 31. Luke Walker, our post hitter, got a little bit. Like I said, some of you guys, James McLeod, he was off the pace. Some of these guys were falling back. And like I said, we'll take another look at this. But watch Ryan Cooper. Watch him. Right there, just got lifted off the ground. And then luckily, he didn't get hit again. And Joseph Clark spins out. And then there he goes to tumble. That is just a shame. And then that was not it. I think the 12 got spun out. Yeah, Ryan Duke spun out Red Bell. And there's Jack Rasmussen. There's Tim Feigl. There they all go. And there's when the 48 is going to make big contact. Oh, right there. Yeah, he hit the 56 right when he spawned back to pit road. Let's ride on board with Red Bell. Got involved in that. Let's ride on board with her. She made her way through it, kind of. But she was right behind when Ryan Cooper got lifted, trying to board. Oh. Oh, man. Yeah, then she got spun by Ryan Juke. But we'll take it to green. Oh, wow, guys, that just failed. I just missed the green flag. Oh, man. But anyway. Oh, caution's out again? For what? What the hell did caution come out for? Oh, wow. Caution's out again. I don't even know what it's out. Oh, 14 is on pit road. I think it's out for him. Justin Perry has a problem. Oh boy, let's see what happened. Alright guys, now that all that crazy crap is done, we could get back to racing. And this is almost the end of the race right here as Eric Burton holding on to the lead. But here comes the Budweiser pink car. Here comes Aaron Williams. He's gonna go to the inside. He's gonna make a move. He'll go to the bottom. And it's two laps to go next time by. Aaron Williams gets the spot. And we got some cars that are out of the race. That are slow. And then they go to the bottom. Oh, the 43 is slow. Oh my god. We got a lot of cars that are slow. And we got cars dancing on pit road, if you just noticed that. Doing the hokey pokey. But anyway. There goes the 20. There goes the 29. And he's got the lead right now. But there they go into the corner. Is anybody on pit road? Nope. The line car slow, but there's William Duncan. Look at William Duncan get the run right there. Aaron Williams is holding on to it. Can Aaron Williams get the win here today? And he's got it right now, but he's got to hold on to it. There's a 32 right behind him. They're coming to the line. Michael Jeter's right there, and Eric Burton's got his chance, but there's Sean Henley. Sean Henley could get his shot as well. But one more lap to go. Here comes Michael Jeter. The 32 is going to have to make a move on Aaron Williams. And Aaron Williams get his second win of the season. But here he comes. There goes the 78. But here comes the 32 on the inside. He's going to make a move. He's going to have to move him out the way. And he can't do it. Here comes Aaron Williams down the racetrack. Aaron Williams is holding on to it here at Australia. Here he comes into the corner. Aaron Williams is doing all he could do right now. And Aaron Williams and Michael Jeter is going to try to make the move. Here comes Michael Jeter. But Aaron Williams is going to hold him off and win here in Australia. Oh, and he blows up at the end of the race. What? Have you ever? No, I have never. And he blows up at the end of the race after winning. Oh man, he's gonna have to be like Clint Boyer and walk to victory lane. Well, we actually had somebody else retire. I think that was a 50. Well, we had 1, 2. We had 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Yeah, we had somebody else retire. So we had like 33 cars finish this race. Because 9 cars are out. So we had 34 for a minute. But anyway, race is over. And let's take you back. Let's take you to where Aaron Williams just blew up. 39 just blew up too, I believe. Wow. Thank Cody Lamas. He just blew up too. Let's watch this. Watch this. He just blows up and then he goes down the racetrack. Wow. Wow, that is insane right there. Aaron Williams, he just blows up right there. After winning Australia, winning the race. He just kaput, blows up, and I think Cody Lamas blew up too. Did he blow up? Somebody, I think he hit somebody. Yeah, wait a minute. No, oh, I think he hit the pit road wall. Oh, no. Eric Burton hit the pit road wall. Wow. What a amount of events here today. Oh, Connor Breeden hit it too. Where did Connor Breeden finish? He finished 23rd. And it's Dylan Pote. I don't know where he finished. There's the 28. I think he hit the pit road wall too. This is all coming down to the end of the race. Yeah, he hit the pit road wall as well. And anyway. Oh, whoa. Seth and Dylan made contact. Wait a second. Oh, Seth Cole had a little bit of words with Dylan. I don't know what that was. But we'll take you to the results. Well, guys, here's the finishing results. And look at this top 10. Sean Henley was... I never even talked about him up in the top 10 too much. William Duncan, I talked about him. Eric Burton, this was a statement race for him, and he almost had it, but got passed at the end. Aaron Williams, William Duncan, and Eric Burton. Michael Jeter came out of nowhere. Trent Dunham, Luke Walker, Jacob Lawler. This was a statement race for him, Pichu Walker, and Dylan. Dylan Pote finishing 10th. He's just moving up. He's been having a few good races lately. And there's Cody Lamas, another good finish. Alexander Williams, Charles Jackson, Preston Plourd, Seth Cole, that was a statement race for him. He made a decent statement, finishing 15th. Danny Wells, Peter Saviano, Lyndon Wright, 18th. Not too shabby for him. Ryan Jute, Evan Gattuso, rounds out the top 20. And Jeremy McMurray, James Qualls finished 21st. He got lucky right there by finishing 21st. So, I'd say. There's Richard Johnson, Barney Ward, Jay Juke, Justin Perry, Aaron Mason. And Aaron Mason was out from a wreck. And there's Xavier Livingston, there's Red Bell, Hayden Klein, Jack Rasmussen, Tim Feigl is out from that big wreck that happened with Ryan Cooper flipping, Ryan Acosta, Joseph Clark, James McLeod with T-Bone Ryan Cooper, and Ryan Cooper took a tumble at this track. And his season has just been very bad. And we had 18 leading changes. That was closing on the top lead changes we had all season, I believe. I think we had more than that at Talladega, I don't know. But let's take you to the points. And James Qualls is still the points leader. He's actually gained a lot on his points, even though Eric Burton and Preston Plourd are right there. Richard Johnson dropped. So did Kyle Sanuski drop from second to fifth in points. Trent Dunham moved up to 6th in points. Eric Burton is closing. He is really making a statement this season. So is Jacob Lawler. Peachy Walker is up in the top 10 in points. And Dylan Poteet, he is 20th in points. If he gets a win or anything and move up, he could be a wild card contender. I'll tell you that much. And now Aaron Williams has his second win on the season. That's more than what he got last season. He only got one last season. Wow. And there's James McLeod. He drops out of the top 10 for the first time this season. He didn't have a great race today. And that shows. Red Bell drops out of the top 10. There's Cody Lamas. Look at him making a move. He did not have a great start to the season. Now he's up to 13th in the points. He's doing pretty good in all three series. That's one thing he could say. Jack Rasmussen making some moves. He's got a win. And there's Peter Saviano. There's Jay Juke up here. There's William Duncan making himself noticed again. There's Dougie Shears also making himself noticed. He needs to get a win along with Seth and Dylan. They need to get wins to try to get themselves up in the wild card picture. There's Danny Wells. There's Ryan Acosta. There's Aaron Mason. And there's Alexander Williams. There's Jeremy McMurray, Ryan Juke. A lot of these guys are way out of contention right now. Dylan Young, Barney Ward. Lyndon Wright actually moving up. He's almost solidly into the top 30, even though he's 30th. He moved up three spots. And last week, Sean moved up. There's Justin Perry. There's Ryan Cooper moving down. Xavier Livingston moving down as well. And we will see you next weekend.